on the 21st day of the month of September, in an early year of a decade not too long before our own, the human race encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. This terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
Little shop of horrors, now, oh, 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 no. Little shop of horrors, bop, shoo, bop. Little shop of terror, watch them drop. Little shop of horrors, now, oh, 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 no. Shing-a-ling, what a creepy thing to be happening.
Look out,
look out, look out. Shang-a-lang, feel the storm and drang in the air, yeah, 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 yeah. Sha-la-la, stop right where you are, don't you move a thing. You better, telling you you better. Tell your mama, something's gonna get her. She better, everybody better beware. Best believe it, something's gonna get ya. You betcha, betcha watch your back and your tail. Come a, come a, come a little shop of horrors, bop, shoo, bop. You'll never stop the terror, little shop of horrors, no. Oh, oh, no, oh, oh, no, oh, oh, no.
Nothing, Mr. Mushnick.
Oh, yi, this kid's gonna make my hair turn gray, I swear to... Well, look who finally decided to show up to work.
Good morning, Mr. Mushnick.
What morning? It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Not that it matters. Who gets customers when you run a flower shop on Skid Row?
I'm sorry.
Seymour, what is going on back there?
Very little, Mr. Mushnick.
Audrey, you better go back there and see what he's doing. He's probably breaking all my pots, and I can't afford to keep pot. Audrey, where'd you get that shiner?
Shiner?
It's that no good greasy boyfriend of yours, isn't it? He's been beating up on you again. I'm starting to think he's not such a nice boy.
You don't meet nice boys when you live on Skid Row, Mr. Mushnick.
Hey, I got these plants repotted for you, Mr. Mushnick.
Seymour, look what you've done to my inventory!
No, don't yell at Seymour, Mr. Mushnick!
Oh. Hi, Audrey. You look radiant today. Is that new eye makeup?
Oh, I'll clean it up before any of the customers get here.
Well, that should give you plenty of time. Look, God, what an existence I got. Misfit employees, bums on the sidewalk, business is lousy. My life is a living hell. You urchins off my stoop! It's bad enough I got those winos permanently decorating my storefront that I need you 6 worthless ragamuffins completing the picture.
Aw, we ain't bothering nobody, are we, Crystal?
No, we're not, Ronette.
You should be in school.
We're on split shift.
Right. We went to school till 5th grade, then we split.
Well, how do you intend to better yourselves?
Better ourselves? Mister, when you from Skid Row? Ain't no such thing. Alarm goes off at 7 and you start uptown. You put in your 8 hours for the powers that have always been. Till it's 5 p.m.
are broke.
Downtown,
where your life's a joke.
Downtown,
when you find your token, you go
home to Skid Row.
Home to Skid Row.
Yes, you go.
Downtown,
where the cabs don't stop.
Downtown,
where the food is slop.
Downtown,
where the hotbeds slop in the snow.
Down on Skid Row.
Uptown, you cater to a million jerks. Uptown, your messengers and mailroom clerks. Eating all your lunches at the hot dog carts. The bosses take your money and they break your hearts. Uptown, you cater to a million whores.
Go.
Downtown, where the guys are drips.
Downtown,
where they rip your slips.
Downtown,
where relationships are no go.
Down on
Skid
Row.
My life, I've always been poor. I keep asking God what I'm for, and he tells me, gee, I'm not sure. Sweep that floor, kid, oh. I started life as an orphan, a child of the street, here on Skid Row. He took me and gave me shelter, a bed, crust of bread, and a job. Treats me like dirt, calls me a slob, which I am. So I live
downtown.
That's your home address, you live
downtown.
When your life's a mess, you live
downtown.
Where depression's just status quo.
Down on Skid Row.
Constantly pray I'll get out of here. Please won't somebody say I'll get out of here. Someone give me my shot or I'll rot here.
Downtown, there's no rules for us. Downtown, cause it's dangerous. Downtown,
someone tell me I still
can
get out of here.
Look at that, 7:30 and we didn't sell so much as a fern. Don't bother coming in tomorrow.
You don't mean...
You can't mean.
I mean I'm closed, finished, kaput.
You can't.
I can't what? I'm closing this god and customer forsaken place for good.
Mr. Mushnick, forgive me for saying so, but has it ever occurred to you that maybe what this firm needs is to move in a new direction?
What Seymour's trying to say, Mr. Mushnick, is... Well, Seymour, why don't you run in the back and fetch those strange and interesting new plans you've been working on? You see, Mr. Mushnick, some of these strange and interesting new plans Seymour's been tinkering around with are really unusual, and we were both thinking that maybe some of these strange and interesting new plans, prominently displayed and advertised, could attract business.
I'm afraid she isn't feeling very well today.
There. Isn't that bizarre?
At least. What kind of weirdo plant is that, Seymour?
I don't know. It looks like some sort of flytrap, but I haven't been able to identify it in any of my books. So I gave it my own name. I call it Nodri, too.
After me?
I hope you don't mind. You see, sir, if you put a strange and interesting plant like this here in the window, then maybe...
Then maybe what, Seymour? Do you have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in the window...
Excuse me! I couldn't help but notice that strange and interesting plant in the window. What is it?
It's an Audrey too.
I've never seen anything like it before.
No one has.
Where did you get it?
Well, you remember that total eclipse of the sun a few weeks ago?
Da-doo.
Well, I was walking in the wholesale flower district that day.
Shoo, da-doo.
And I passed by this place where this old Chinese man,
Chang da-doo.
He sometimes sells me weird and exotic cuttings.
Snip, da-doo.
Because he knows strange plants are my hobby.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-doo.
We didn't have anything unusual there that day.
Nope, da-doo.
So I was about to, you know, just walk on by.
Good for you.
When suddenly... And without warning, there was a total eclipse of the sun. It got very dark, and I heard a strange humming sound like something from another world.
Daddy.
And when the light came back, this weird plant was just sitting there.
Oopsie-doo.
Just stuck in, you know, among the zinnias.
Audrey too.
Well, I could have sworn it hadn't been there before, but the old Chinese man sold it to me anyway. And for $1.95.
Well, that's an unusual story and a fascinating plant. Good day. Well, while I'm here, I might as well buy $50 worth of roses.
$50?
$50?
$50?
Yes, sir. Right away, sir. Audrey, fetch this man $50 worth of American Red Beauty roses.
Can you break 100?
No. Unfortunately, we've closed the register for the day.
Well, I'll just have to buy twice as many, won't I?
Twice as many?
Twice as many?
Twice as many.
Oh my god.
Thank you very much. Yes, sir. That is one strange and interesting plant.
Oh my
god! $100!
You know if I've seen $100?
Seymour! Why are you just standing there? Put that, what do you call it?
Audrey 2.
Put that Audrey 2 in the window where the passers-by can see.
Seymour,
my god, I never would have believed it.
I'm so proud of you.
My children, I'm taking us all to dinner.
I'd love to, Mr. Mushnick, but I've got a date.
With that no good, Nick? I'm telling you, Audrey. You don't need a date with him. You need major medical.
He's a professional.
What kind of professional drives a motorcycle and wears a black leather jacket?
He's a rebel, Mr. Mushnick, but he makes good money. And besides, he's the only fella I got. Well, anyway, enjoy dinner. Good night, Seymour. Good night, Mr. Mushnick.
Good night.
Poor girl.
Are we still going to dinner?
You're not going anywhere, Seymour. You're gonna stay here and take care of that sick plant. How come it's fainting all the time?
I told you, she's been giving me trouble. The Audrey 2 is not a healthy girl.
Strictly between us. Neither's the Audrey 1.
If only I knew what breed it is. What genus, but it's nowhere in the books.
Well, my advice to you, Krubborn, is to figure it out. And fast! Look what the little beauty did for business.
I know.
Seymour, nurse that plant back to health. I'm counting on you.
I know.
You do?
I do.
So fix! Good night.
Aw, Tui. I don't know what else to do for you. Mr. Mushnick and Audrey, they just met you, but I've been going through this with you for weeks. Grow and wilt, spurt and flop. Are you sickly, little plant? You're just plain stubborn. What is it you want? What is it you need? I've given you sunshine. I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing but heartache and hurt. I'm begging you sweetly. I'm down on my knees. Oh, please grow for me. I've given you plant food and water to sip. I've given you potash. You've given me zip. Oh, God, how I missed you. Oh, pot, how you tease. Now, please grow for me. Given you southern exposure to get you to thrive. I've pinched you back hard like I'm supposed to. You're barely alive. I've tried you with levels of moisture from desert to mud. I've given you grow lights and mineral supplements. What do you want from me, blood? Ouch! Goddamn roses, damn thorns. Clumsy me. So wait, look what I did. Wait. Hey, you're opening up! I wonder what made you do that! I think I know what made you do that. I guess a few drops couldn't hurt. As long as you don't make a habit out of it or anything.
I've given you sunlight. I've given you rain. Looks like you're not happy, lest I open a vein. I'll give you a few drops, if that'll appease. Now, please, oh, 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 please, grow for me.
Thus, we conclude our interview with Seymour Krelborn, the young botanical. Do you mind if I call you a genius?
Gosh, no.
The genius who's developed a new breed of plant life hitherto unknown on this planet, the Audrey 2. Oh, and one last question, Mr. Krelborn. Do you feed it anything special?
Special? No, it's a secret formula, but it's not hard to come by.
I see. Well, thanks for dropping by.
Now, I would like to remind our listeners that the Audrey 2 is on display exclusively at Mushnick Skid Row Florist. Open
six days a week, 10 to 6. WSKID!
The address! The address! Mention the... Oh, well. Still great advertising. I can't believe it. It couldn't be happening. Pinch me, girls. It couldn't be happening. All of the sudden success coming out of the blue. I put a sign up right in the front window. an advertisement right in the front window. Stop in and see the amazing new plant, Audrey, too. And the really remarkable thing is that people, they do. Seymour, that twerp of a klutz, finally did something right. Audrey, too, drives them nuts. What a wonderful blessing this plant should exist. Should rake in the bucks for me hand over fist. Wait, it's Seymour.
Seymour!
Well, how'd I do?
You was great, Seymour. You sounded sexier than the Wolfman.
But you didn't mention the address of the shop. How many times have I told you?
I'm sorry, I was nervous. Hey, where's Audrey? She said she'd be here.
Forget about Audrey. I got 3 more radio interviews lined up for tomorrow, and the Skid Row Herald Examiner wants a picture.
If I had a mother, she'd be so proud of me.
You're an overnight sensation, Seymour. Who'd have believed it? One day he pushed a broom, nothing in his news but gloom and doom. Then he lit a fuse and give him room. Stand aside and watch that mother blow. Explosion, bam, kerboom. Don't it go to show you never know? Seymour was in a funk. He was number zero, who'da thunk? He'd become a hero, just a punk. He was a forgotten so-and-so. Then one day,
crash, kerplunk.
Don't it go to show you never know? We're gonna sing for you. All the world used to screw him. Biff, wimp, pow, now they interview him. And they clamor to put his remarks on the air. Starting to appreciate him, and all because of that strange little plant over there. Observant, here's a check. Everything is landing in his lap.
I just cut my hand and in a snap, something out of Edgar Allan Poe has happened.
Sam Kazap, don't it go to show you never know. One day you're slinging hash, feeling so rejected, lightning flash. You get resurrected, make a splash. Now you're in the big bravissimo. And with the thunder crash, crash kerplunk, bam kerboom, Sam kazunk, Sam kazoo, zowie powie, holy cow. He ordered up a rainbow to go. Well, pal, look out below. Don't it go to show you never know.
Got mad.
So dump the chump. Get another guy and let him protect you.
And we got one all picked out for ya.
A little botanical genius.
And she ain't talking about George Washington Carver.
Seymour?
Bingo.
Oh, I could never be Seymour's girl. We're just friends. And besides, I've got a past.
And who doesn't?
I certainly
knew about it.
I don't deserve a sweet, kind, suddenly successful guy like Seymour.
Mm-mm-mm. This child suffers from low self-image.
You have a point.
She have a problem.
I know Seymour is the greatest, but I'm dating a semi-sadist. So I've got a black eye and my arms in a cast. Still, that Seymour's a cutie. Or if not, he's got inner beauty. And I dream of a place where we could be together at last.
And what kind of a
place is that, honey? An emergency room?
Oh, no. It's just a daydream of mine. A little development I dream of just off the interstate. Not fancy like Levittown. Just a little street in a little suburb, far, far from urban Skid Row. The sweetest, greenest place where everybody has the same little lawn out front and the same little flagstone patio out back. And all the houses are so neat and pretty because they all look just alike. Oh, I dream about it all the time. Just me and the toaster and a sweet little guy. Like Seymour. A matchbox of our own. A fence of real chain link. A grill out on the patio. Disposal in the sink. A washer and a dryer. And an ironing machine. In a tract house that we share. Somewhere that's green. He rakes and trims the grass. He loves to mow and weed. I cook like Betty Crocker, and I look like Donna Reed. There's plastic on our furniture to keep it neat and clean. In the pine soul scented air, somewhere that's green. Between our frozen dinners and our bedtime, 9:15, we snuggle watching Lucy on our big, enormous 12-inch screen. I'm his December bride. He's father, he knows best. Our kids watch Howdy Doody as the sun sets in the west. A picture out of Better Homes and Gardens magazine. Far from Skid Row, I dream we'll go somewhere that's
close for renovations.
For sleeping up and grooming.
Cause customers are flocking.
And business has been booming.
We need refrigeration in our new improved display. So we're close for renovation today.
Yes, indeed, this is the shop you've heard about on Channel 5 News. The Audrey 2 is on display exclusively here.
Close the decoration, cause fortune has been smiling. So now we're due for painting, new plumbing and retiling. We'll make a ship-shaped showplace of a little shop and then tomorrow we'll be open again.
Have you finished yet, Seymour?
I'm trying, but all these band-aids make it kinda hard.
You've been getting hurt so much lately.
I know, right? Seems like every time I pick up a pair of pruning shears, I slip.
We're close for renovation, for swabbing down and brooming, cause business has been thriving since all these years been blooming. The phones have not stopped ringing with the customers who say,
another bunch of peonies,
another dozen daisies please,
geraniums and anemones,
forget-me-nots and fleur-de-lis,
we've got this home delivery,
I'm paid in fulls and CODs. We're close for renovation today.
Order to Miss Shiva?
Miss Shiva. Oh, right, Miss Shiva! I forgot.
You forgot? Seymour, they're our biggest funeral account. This big, enormous family. And they're dropping off like flies! Seymour, if we lose this account because of you, you are finished! God! Oh, stupid stool!
You know, sometimes I think Mr. Mushnik's too hard on you.
Oh, I don't mind. After all, I owe him everything. He took me out of Skid Row home for boys when I was just a little tyke. He gave me a warm place to sleep. Under the counter. Nice things to eat, like meatloaf and water, floors to sweep, toilets to clean, and every other Sunday off.
You know, I think you ought to raise your expectations, Seymour. Now that we're getting successful, I mean. Why don't you start with some new clothes? No offense, it's just with all the interviews and photo sessions coming up, a big, important experimental botanist has to look the part.
I'm a very bad shopper, Audrey. I don't have good taste like you.
I could help you pick things out.
You could?
Sure.
You'd go shopping with me.
Sure.
You'd be seen with me in a public place like a department store?
Sure.
Tonight?
I can't tonight. I've got a date, but some other time.
Yeah, sure, I'll pencil you in.
I bet you get a lot of dates now, huh?
Not dates, exactly, but a lot of garden clubs have been calling, asking me to give lectures.
Gee.
I know, right? Imagine me giving lectures. I never even finished grade school.
Well, that's okay. You have life experience.
Some experience? I don't even know what it's like to fly in an airplane.
Me neither.
Or eat a fancy dinner at Howard Johnson's.
Me neither.
Or ride a motorcycle.
Oh, it's no big deal. And besides, it's dangerous.
It is?
Extremely dangerous. Well, gee, I'd better go fix my face. My date will be here any minute.
Skid Row.
I'm afraid that kind of information's gonna cost you a dollar.
Not a problem. There you go.
It's right over there. But if you're like the thousands of others flocking to see the Audrey 2, you better come back tomorrow, man. The shop is closed today.
Woo!
Took your dollar.
Oh, I'm not here to shop, girls. I'm here to pick up my date.
Can we, by any chance, talking about a girl with a black eye?
And several other medical problems?
Well, as a matter of fact.
Ladies,
please, peace, truce, I'm friendly. You want some nitrous oxide?
Why don't you get lost, Vitalis Brains? The last thing that Audrey needs is more of your kind.
My kind is a very nice kind, girls. I'm not a monster.
What else would you call it?
I would call it a... I would call it an occupational hazard.
Say what?
You see, girls, my line of work requires a special fascination with human pain and suffering. Allow me to explain.
When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did. Like shooting puppies with a BB gun. I'd poison guppies, and when I was done, I'd find a pussycat and bash in its head. And that's when my mama said,
what did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tendencies pay. Son, be a dentist. You have a talent for causing things pain. Son, be a dentist.
Son, be a dentist.
Be people will pay you to be inhumane.
Inhumane.
Your temperament's wrong for the priesthood. Teaching would suit you still less. Son, be a dentist.
You'll be a success.
Here he is, girl, the leader of the flat.
Watch him suck up that gas.
Oh my God.
He's a dentist and he'll never ever be any good. Who wants their teeth done by the marquis de Sade? Oh, that hurts. I'm not numb.
Oh, shut up. Open wide. Here I come. I am your dentist, and I enjoy the career that I picked.
Love it.
I am your dentist, and I get off on the pain I inflict.
Really love it.
When I start extracting those molars, you girls will be screaming like holy rollers.
Dentist.
And though it may cause my patients distress,
distress.
Somewhere in heaven above me, I know that my mama's proud of me. Yeah. 'Cause I'm a dentist and a success. Say ah. Say ah. Say ah. How you doing?
Fine, thank you, but the shop's closed.
Oh, I'm not here to shop, buddy. I'm here to pick up my Oh, but is that the new plant they've been talking about on the news? The what do you call it?
Audrey 2.
Oh, cute name, it's catchy. Nice plant, it's so big.
Thank you, I raised it myself. But if you don't mind, we're really not supposed to let anyone be.
No, but I hear it's some kind of new species or something.
That's what they tell me. They see you're really gonna have to get out because we
just can't. It's okay, Seymour. This is my boyfriend, Seymour. Orange Grubbelo. DDS.
You say you raised this thing, kid, right?
Right.
Well, if I were you, I sure as hell wouldn't keep it down under a barrel in a skid row dump like this. That avocado there could be a ticket to the stars, man. Take it to any floor shop in town and name your price. Somebody'd even make you a goddamn partner to get their hands on this thing.
I don't care. I'm happy here.
Seymour's very loyal.
Was somebody talking to you?
Oh, no. Excuse me.
Excuse me what?
Excuse me, doctor. Doctor, excuse me, doctor.
And that's better. Anyways, I'm telling you, kid, that thing's a big green gold mine. Get your ass out of this dump and take the plant with you. You hear me talking?
I hear you.
He hears him!
Shouldn't we be leaving now? Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry what?
I'm sorry, doctor, doctor, I'm sorry, doctor.
You gotta train him, eh, stud? Well, my bike's outside, and it's double parked. But you think about what I said, kid. I mean it. Think about it.
Yeah, sure, I'll think about it.
You'll think about it.
You do that. All right, Audrey, let's go. You got the handcuffs?
They're right in my bag.
Let's bounce.
He'll think about it. He'll think about it.
I don't like that guy, Mr. Mushnick, and you should see the way he talks to Audrey.
Gotten him, I'll know the kid just said he'll mull it over.
Well, no wonder she looks so unhealthy all the time. It's enough to make you sick.
If he left me, if Seymour left me, why then I'd be right back where I started, which is broken, starving.
Sweet and good and beautiful as she is, she deserves a prince, not a sadistic creep like him.
Close to bankrupt.
What a louse.
Beset, befuddled, and bereft. That's what I'd be if Seymour left.
He's a disgrace to the dental profession, Tui.
Seymour!
Sir!
would you like to be my son? How would you like to be my own adopted boy? I never liked him much before, but count the cash that's in the drawer. I've got no choice, I'm much too poor.
What for?
Say yes, be your dad. I want to see you climbing up my family tree. I used to think you left a stench, but now I see that you're immense, so I'm proposing be my son. Mushnik and son, sounds great. Three words with the ring of fate. So say you'll incorporate with me. A forest dream come true. Mushnik and his boy chick you. What business will do for FTD? How about it, Seymour, be my son? Just say the word, I'll have my lawyer on the phone.
Now, Mr. Mushnik, don't be rash. You always said that I was trash.
I was joking!
Sir, I'm joking!
Use the physical expression of my pride, of the sweet paternal Michigans I've held pent up inside. Yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi-yi
Gee.
So?
Well.
Well? I.
You?
Go ahead and say it, Seymour. Tell me that you will.
Gee, I'd really like to, but.
I'll hold my breath until.
Okay, you win, I'll be your son!
Hooray, I win, you'll be my son!
Roll up the papers, Dad, I'm touched, I really am. And when you reach age 83, I'll let you come move in with me.
You swear?
I promise.
What a son. Mushnik and son, that's that. Officially, I'm your brat. Consider the matter closed and done. Now to the world, let's stick our senior and junior stick. Through thin and through thick, through sloppy and slick.
So come kiss me quick.
Please don't make me sick. Mushnik and son. Oi!
Bye, Dad. His son. I'm his son. Sudden changes surround me. Lady Luck came and found me. Thanks a million for making the magic you do. Thanks to you, sweet Petunia. Mushnik's taken a junior. And someday, when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you. Aw, oh, Tui, who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side these past few weeks? So what if I've had a few dizzy spells, a little lightheadedness? It's been worth it, old pal. Well, Tui, I'm getting a little hungry. I'm gonna run down to Schmendrick's and get a bite to eat. I'll see you later. Oh boy, here we go again. Look, Tui, I haven't got much left. Just give me a few more days to heal and then we can start again on the left hand.
Feed me!
I beg your pardon.
Feed me!
Tui, you talked! You opened up your trap, your thing, and you said...
Feed me, Krillborn! Feed me now!
I can't!
I'm starving!
Oh, boy.
I need some food!
I know, but you can't squeeze blood from a...
More! More!
Well, I haven't got any more. What do you want me to do, slit my wrists? Look... How about I run down to the corner and pick you up some nice chopped sirloin?
Must be blood!
Tui, that's disgusting.
Must be fresh!
I don't want to hear this.
Feed me!
Does it have to be human?
Feed me!
Does it have to be mine?
Feed me.
Where am I supposed to get it?
Feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long. That's right, boy. You can do it. Feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long. 'Cause if you feed me, Seymour, I can grow up big and strong.
You eat blood, Audrey, too, let's face it. How am I supposed to keep on feeding you? Kill people?
I'll make it worth your while.
What?
You think this is all a coincidence, baby? The sudden success around here? Your adoption papers?
Look, you're a plant, an inanimate object.
Does this look inanimate to you, punk? If I can talk and I can move, who's to say I can't do anything I want?
Like what?
Like deliver, pal. Like see you get everything your secret greasy heart desires. Would you like a Cadillac car? Or a guest shot on Jack Paar? How about a day with Patty Lamar? You're gonna get it.
No thanks, Huey. Kind of you to offer, but...
How'd you like to be a big wheel dining out for every meal? I'm the plant that can make it all real. You're gonna get it. I'm your genie, I'm your friend, I'm your willing slave. Take a chance, just feed me, and you know the kind of eats, the kind of red hot treats, the kind of sticky licky sweets I crave. Come on, Seymour, don't be a putt. Trust me and your life will surely rival King Tut's. Show a little initiative, work up the guts, you'll get it.
I don't know.
Come on, kid, what'll it be? Money? Girl? One particular girl? How about that Audrey?
Think it over.
There must be someone you could 86 real quiet like and get me some lunch. How'd you like a room at the Ritz? Wrapped in velvet, covered in glitz. A little nookie gonna clean up your tits, you'll get it.
Gee, I'd like a Harley machine, tooling around like I was James Dean, making all the guys on the corner turn green.
So go get it! If you wanna be profound, you really gotta justify. Take a breath and look around, a lot of folks deserve to die.
Whoa, 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 wait a minute! That's not a very nice thing to say.
But it's true, isn't it?
No. I don't know anyone that deserves to get chopped up and fed to a hungry plant.
Sure you do.
Stupid woman. Christ, what a friggin' scatterbrain.
I'm sorry, Doctor.
Get the hell inside and pick up your goddamn sweater, you dizzy cow.
Yes, Doctor. Right away, Doctor. Oh, hi, Seymour. I just have my sweater.
Moment, you little slut. How do you like that stupid dame forgets a freaking sweater? I swear, for stupid Edward screwed on.
Oh, I'm in that hurt!
Moment!
If you want a rationale, it isn't very hard to see.
Stop and think it over, pal. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. He's so nasty, treating her rough.
Smacking her around and always talking so tough.
You need blood and he's got more than enough.
I need fun, he's got more than enough.
You need blood and he's got more than enough.
So go get it.
Thank you.
next.
I believe that's me, Dr. Stravillo.
Do you have an appointment?
We met yesterday. Seymour Krelborn?
Oh, the guy with the plant.
Right.
And the band-aids.
Right.
And the gun?
Right.
Why are you pointing a gun at me, Seymour?
I'm
someone a little nervous about seeing a dentist.
Nervous? No, I'm not nervous.
It's only gonna hurt a little.
Oh, you don't understand. I'm not here to get my teeth examined.
Boy, Seymour, well, your mouth's a mess. You've got cavities, you've got plaque impacted, you're obsessed.
I am?
You're in need of a complete oral examination. We'll start with the wisdom tooth.
Oh, no!
Rip the little bugger out of there. What do you say?
I gotta go.
Oh, there's always time for dental hygiene, Seymour. Have you ever seen the results of a neglected mouth? This could be you.
It could?
Unless I take immediate dental action. Let's get started.
Wait! Aren't you gonna give me Novocaine?
What for? It dulls the senses.
But it'll hurt!
Only till you pass out.
What's that?
This is a drill, Seymour.
It's rusty!
It's an antique! You see, they don't make instruments like these anymore. Sturdy, heavy, dull. This is gonna be a challenge, Seymour. No! This is gonna be a pleasure. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna want some gas for this one.
Gas?
Oh, nitrous oxide.
Oh, thank God. I thought you weren't gonna give me any.
Silly Seymour, gas isn't for you, it's for me. Oh, you see, I really, really, really want to enjoy this, and I find that the little bit of giggle gas before we get started increases my pleasure enormously. Oh, as a matter of fact, I'll use my special gas mask for this one. Oh, stay right there, Seymour. I'll be with you in a moment.
Now, do it now. Well, he's gassing himself to a palpable stupor. The timing's ideal and the moment is super. Too ready and fire and blow the sick bastard away. Now, do it now. Just a flicker of pressure right here on the trigger, and Audrey won't have to put up with that pig for another day. Now for the girl. Now for the plant. Now, yes, I will. But I can't.
Oh, boy, Seymour, I am flying now. Oh, the things we're gonna do to your mouth.
Well, I guess I've had about enough of this stuff. I'll just take the mask off now and... Hey, Seymour. Guess what?
What?
The mask, it's stuck. I can't get it off.
Jesus Christ. I can asphyxiate in here.
Oh, come give me a hand, Seymour, won't you?
Well.
Well? He says, well? I don't think you understand.
Don't be fooled if I should giggle like a sappy, happy dope. It's just the gas. Oh, it's got me high. But don't let that fact deceive you. Any moment I could die. Oh, no. Though I giggle and I chortle, bear in mind I'm not immortal. Well, this whole thing strikes me funny, I don't know. 'Cause it really is an awful way to go.
It was an ethical dilemma, lest they help him get the master if he doesn't have a prayer. So the gun was never fired, but a way it transpired, I could finish him with simple laissez-faire.
Now,
what we have here is a tricky moral problem. Do I help
now.
Him with the mask or let him go for lack of air?
Help
couldn't shoot
now.
Him when I tried, but the fates are on my side. I can off the guy by staying in the chair.
Don't be fooled if I should chuckle like hyenas in a zoo. It's just the gas. It turns me on. But don't let my mirth deceive you. Any moment I'll be gone. Oh, no. And my vital signs are failing, cause the oxide I'm inhaling is as difficult as hell to catch my breath. Are you mad? Or hard of hearing? Or relieved? My end is nearing. Are you satisfied? I've laughed myself down.
Death. I'll get it for you right away. Audrey, here.
The amazing, the most wonderful.
$5,000 worth of African violets? $2,000 worth of baby blue eyes? The pink, the green, the yellow, and the purple.
She's got amazing, multicolored warts.
Yes, ma'am.
Warts.
You, urchins, come here. Take this to the Japanese garden and this to the Dutch pavilion. Now go, go.
Oh.
Audrey, I'm late for my lawyer appointment. Make sure Seymour gets the wolf bane to Corman.
You name it, we sell it.
Mushnik, she's real pretty.
Please hold.
There she
Mushnik
is.
Son,
isn't
can
he
hold?
Amazing?
Mushnik and son,
you
can
have a favorite florist.
Why, yes, ma'am. Funerals are our specialty. Oh, Seymour, can you help me with these bones?
Thank you, sir. Come again.
Mushnik and son, Skid Row's favorite florist.
Mushnik and son, Skid Row's favorite florist. Can you hold, please?
Now, you were saying, flowers for a prom passage.
Flowers for an entourage.
Flowers to the funeral home.
Leaving from St. Andrew's Roman Catholic Church in 9th and Vine.
$40, hold the line.
First thing in the morning,
Fine.
You'll be there in the morning.
Can you hold the Rose Bowl? Seymour, the Rose Bowl. You know that big inflated estimate we wrote for the Rose Bowl. Well, it's the Rose Bowl. It seems they wanna buy their flowers here for every single float. Well, you can't keep the tournament waiting.
Mooshnik and son, please hold.
Can you hold?
It's just as the plan foretold.
Just a minute.
It's business like you'd have ever guessed.
Mooshnik and Son.
That was me. That was me.
The business on is channel doing three. Great. So why am I feeling so depressed?
I got 2 tickets to the game. Mooshnik and Son, Skid Row's favorite florist.
7,000 boutonnieres, carnations of the yellow roses.
Please, I've only got 2 ears. Allergic to chrysanthemums.
I'll ask the hardier. Which one would your wife prefer?
Were you waiting long? I'm sorry, sir. 1 minute and I'll get her for you.
Demo, that reporter!
Oh, I thought we finished yesterday.
She wants another interview. Said to bring the plan with you.
Audrey, it's that new account.
Sorry, that's the right amount.
Savings only come in white.
Sir, I'm 2 worn out to fight.
Sorry, those are out of stock.
Demo, look. It's 6
Call back in the morning, will you?
Call back in the morning, can't you?
Call back in the morning, can you?
Call back in the morning, thank you.
Call back in the morning.
What a day. What a day. Seymour, do you mind locking up for me? I'm all in.
1 minute, Audrey. I had something I wanted to show you.
Can I wait until tomorrow?
It won't take very long. I've just been thinking a lot about shopping for a new wardrobe, like you asked me. And well, ta-da.
Seymour.
What do you think?
I don't know.
You don't like it? No. I'll take it off. I'll take it back. I'll burn it. Oh, God, just don't cry. I didn't mean to make you upset. That's the last thing I ever meant to do.
I guess I've just been a little under the weather lately.
Oh. It's Oren, isn't it? You've been down in the dumps ever since his mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Miss him? Oh, I've never been so relieved as to when they told me he'd vanished. It was like a miracle. Not to mention all the money I've saved on Epsom salts and East bandages.
Then what's the matter?
Well, I feel guilty, I guess. I mean, if you were met with foul play or some terrible accident of some kind, then... Well, it's partly my fault, you see, because... Well, secretly, I wished it.
Audrey, don't waste 1 more minute worrying about that creep. There are plenty of guys who would do anything to go out with you. Nice guys.
I don't deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
That's not true.
You don't know the half of it. I've led a terrible life.
Audrey, don't.
I deserve a creep like Oren Scribillo, DDS. Do you know where I met him? In the gutter.
The gutter?
The gutter. It's a night spot. I used to work there on our nights off when we weren't making much money. I'd put on cheap and tasteless outfits. Not nice ones. Like this. Low and nasty apparel and night.
Audrey, that's all behind you now. You have nothing to be ashamed of. You're a very nice girl. I always knew you were. Underneath all the bruises and the handcuffs, you know what I saw? A girl I respected, and I still do. Lift up your head, wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup. Don't have to pretend that suddenly Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
Nobody ever treated me kindly. Daddy left early. Mama was poor. I'd meet a man and I'd follow him blindly. He'd snap his fingers. Me, I'd say sure. Suddenly, Seymour is standing beside me. He don't give me orders. He don't condescend. Suddenly, Seymour is here.
this feeling will last forever. Tell me the bad times are clean washed away.
Please understand that it's still strange and frightening. For losers like I've been, it's so hard to say. Suddenly Seymour.
Suddenly Seymour.
He purified me.
He purified you.
Suddenly Seymour.
Suddenly Seymour.
Audrey, perhaps you'd excuse us for a while. Maybe you'd like to go visit your dentist friend?
That's not very funny, Pop. You know he disappeared.
That's right. He did.
Didn't he?
Forgive me, boy chick.
Seymour, what's he talking about? What's he doing?
Look, why don't you just run along like he said, Audrey? I'll catch up with you in the morning, if that's okay.
Of course it is. Good night, Seymour. Good night, Mr. Mushnick.
Little red dots all over my floor!
You're acting pretty strange, Pop.
Well, I had a pretty strange afternoon, Seymour. You see, after my lawyer appointment, I got called to the police station.
The police?
It seems they're doing a routine investigation into the disappearance of the motorcycle dentist. And when they did that, it seems they found a Mushnick Skid Row florist bag in his office.
What's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Seymour. And then I start to think about little things I've noticed around here. Like little red dots.
I was drinking some Hawaiian punch and it stained.
Yeah. Pretty hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it, Seymour? Especially when they only empty our garbage once a month.
What does that have to do with anything? Wait, where are you going?
If you want something removed in a hurry, it's best not to dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist uniform!
He's got your number now.
I saw it last week and didn't think twice.
He knows just what you've done.
And the little red dot seemed innocent enough.
You got no place to hide.
But then I catch you kissing the dentist's
girlfriend.
You got
nowhere to run.
And it begins to look like a motive.
He knows your life of crime.
Once he's gone, you move in, right?
I think it's supper time.
I'm innocent. Dad, look, I'm innocent.
Then how do you explain this, Seymour?
Picture of a baseball cap?
Your baseball cap, Seymour! They found it in Scrivillo's office and they asked me if I could identify it.
Well, did you?
No! They don't suspect you at all. But what they don't know about is the dots, the uniform, the girlfriend!
Look, I didn't do it.
Then come to the police station and tell them that!
He's got his facts all straight.
Just so my conscience will rest easy.
You know he's on your trail.
If you don't, I'll tell them myself.
He's gonna turn you in.
Will you come?
He's gonna put you in jail.
Okay.
He's USDA prime.
I'll lock up and we can head over.
For my supper time! Girl.
Come out, come out. Think about all those offers. Come out, come out.
Your future with Audrey.
Come out, come out. Ain't no time to turn squeamish. Come out, come out. I swear on all my sports. When he's gone, the world will be yours.
Come on, Seymour, let's head over.
Wait, Dad, don't you want to collect today's checks so you can deposit them in the morning?
You put them in the safe, didn't you?
No.
Why not?
I forgot the combination.
You forgot the combination? Seymour, that's thousands of dollars. Where is it?
It's in the plant.
The money is in the plant?
I thought it would be the safest place to put it. No thief would ever think to look in there, right?
How the hell am I supposed to get it?
Just knock.
Knock? Seymour! 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 Seymour!
Not now.
Is it true Audrey 2 is grand marriage for the Rose Bowl?
Is it true the shop is doing the flowers for the senior prom?
Yes, 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 it's all true.
There's another big hotshot looking for you, Seymour, from uptown. He's basking all over. Where can he find you? You're famous, Seymour.
Is that him?
That's him, Mr. Bernstein.
Thank you, ladies. Seymour Krellman!
Sweetheart, honey, baby, pussycat!
Do I know you?
Of course not. But boy, are you gonna be happy when you do.
Seymour, sweetheart, dollface, bubbler.
Hey, Seymour Krellman, you prince, you. My name is Bernstein, I'm with NBC. I came down here to convince you to do a weekly TV show for me.
Seymour Krellman scavenging tips, you like it? I love it! For half an hour on Sundays at 4. TV's first home gardening program. You're welcome to no ratings, what's up?
They say the meek shall inherit. You know the book doesn't lie. It's not a question of merit. It's about demand and supply. You know the meek gonna get it. And you're a meek little guy. You know the meek are gonna get what's coming to them by and by.
Your own TV show.
Coast to coast, your name is
your face on screen.
Sign it.
Sign it.
Sign that contract!
Isn't it exciting?
Here he is, Miss Luce. We found him. He's right here.
No, please, girls. I don't want to see anyone else today.
My darling, my precious, my sweet, sweet thing. Cutie, sweetness, Seymour, baby doll. I'd like a word with you, lover. I'm sure you know me, the editor's wife. We want your face on the cover. On the December 3rd issue of Life. Yes, the front of Life magazine. Now that's an honor we so seldom grant. We'll send someone here, let's say Thursday, for shots of you and your beautiful plant.
Let's see the meek shall inherit. You know the book doesn't lie. It's not a question of merit. It's not demand, it's supply. You know the meek gonna get it. And you're a meek little guy. You know the meek are gonna get what's coming to them by and by.
Life magazine, oh Seymour, you're gonna make it straight to the top.
How did you do it?
Here he is, sir. Seymour Krellman, owner of the fabulous Audrey 2, America's most amazing and largest unidentified plant.
So this is Seymour Krellman.
We've been trying to reach you, baby. Have your phones been busy? Did you get a telegram?
I don't think so.
Well, it's a good thing I came down in person then. It's a pleasure to meet you, kid. Skip Snip, William Morris Agency. Forget the cable we sent you. It's nice to meet me. The pleasure is yours. Now let my firm represent you. We want to book you on lecturing tours. College, campus, Rotary Club, fetch. The kind of bookings my office can do. Show the plant, then talk, answer questions. It's educational, lucrative too.
My future's starting, I've got to let it. Stick with that plant and G, my bank accounts will thrive. What am I saying? No way, forget it. It's much too dangerous to keep that plant alive. I take these offers, that means more killing. Who knew success would come with messy, nasty strings? I sign these contracts, that means I'm willing to keep on doing bloody, awful, evil things. No! No! There's only so far you can bend! No! No! This nightmare must come to an end! No! No! You've got no alternative, Seymour, old boy. It means you'll be broke again and unemployed. It's the only solution, it can't be avoided. The vegetable must be destroyed. But then, there's Audrey. Lovely Audrey. If life were tawdry and impoverished as before, she might not like me, she might not want me. Without my plant, she might not love me anymore. Where do I sign?
Right on the line. That'll be fine. This copy's mine. Couldn't go wrong. Bye-bye, so long.
You know the meek are gonna get what's coming to them.
You know the meek are gonna get what's coming to them.
Bye.
Can't you see I'm busy?
Tough titty!
What's your language?
Grub!
Give me a break! I gotta write this speech for the lecture tour. It's all about you. Give me some peace and quiet or I'll tell them the truth.
Don't get cute with me. I made you and I can break you.
Well, go ahead and break me. You think it's easy living with all this guilt?
Oh, cut the crap and bring on the meat.
If only you'd eat meat. If only you'd touch a fly or a mouse. But you're so particular.
Oh, come on, Krelborn. I ain't ate since Mooshnik, and that was a week ago.
Look, just hold out one more night, can ya? Life magazine will be here in the morning.
And then you'll find me somebody?
Then, you'll never be hungry again. I promise.
Chow time, Krelborn! Food, food!
I can't take it! I can't take it! Just shut up! Just feed me all the time!
Seymour! What's the matter with you?
It's the matter with me! Don't you think I know it needs food? Don't you think I know it'll die if I don't feed it soon? Don't you think I know?
Seymour! You're hysterical! terrible! What's the big deal about a little plant food? I think running this place all by yourself is too much for you. When did Mr. Mushnik say he'd be back?
Huh?
No, in the letter he left you saying he was at his sister's house.
He's in Czechoslovakia. Right. He could be gone for a very long time. Audrey, can I ask you something?
Well, anything.
Suppose for a moment that the Audrey 2 had never existed. And I was just a nothing again. A nobody. Would you still like me?
I'd still love you, Seymour.
Then it's settled.
What's settled? A gun?
And bullets, and knives, and rat poison. Tomorrow morning, after Life magazine comes and snaps a photo, you know who bites the dust!
Seymour!
They'll snap the photo. I'll take the TV job, we'll be famous! And then there'll be no more nighttime feedings, no more squalling for blood!
What feedings? What blood? I don't get it, Seymour. Bullets, knives, rat poison? You're scaring me.
Audrey, there's nothing to be afraid of. Look, we'll make a new life for ourselves. We'll go to that development that you always dreamed of. Nice little house, nice little car. No plants. No plants at all.
You're talking so peculiar, Seymour.
I'll explain everything to you in the morning. Just please go home, Audrey.
I can't leave you in this condition.
Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything.
Feed me!
Under no circumstances.
Feed me!
I will not, so stop asking!
Feed me!
I can't take much more of this! Look, I'll run down to the corner and pick you up a pound of rare roast beef. Maybe that'll hold you till Life magazine gets here.
Uh-uh. No way.
Look, it's my last offer, yes or no.
It's better than nothing.
Good. Done. Fine. Great. And don't think you're getting dessert, Tui.
Saying, go to Seymour, talk to Seymour. I drank some tea, but gee, the feeling wasn't gone. Seymour, sweetheart, tell me, darling, what's been going on?
Hey, little lady, hello.
What? Who said that?
You're looking cute as can be.
Is there somebody in here?
You're looking mighty sweet.
Seymour, Seymour.
No, it ain't Seymour. It's me.
Oh, my God.
Your friendly Audrey, too. This plant is talking to you.
I don't believe this.
Believe it, baby. It talks.
Am I dreaming this?
No, and you ain't in Kansas neither.
Something's very wrong here.
Oh, relax and go with it, doll. Do me a favor, will you, sweetheart?
A favor?
I need some water in the worst way. Look at my branches. I'm a goner, honey. Come on and give me a drink.
I don't know if I should.
Hey, little lady, be nice.
Well, you just want water, right?
Sure do, I'll drink it straight.
Your branches are dry, poor thing.
Don't need no glass and no ice.
I'll get the can.
Don't need no twist of lime. And now it's supper time. Relax, sweetheart, and it'll be easier. Join your dentist friend in Mushnik. They're right inside.
Oh my God, Audrey, no! Get off her, get off her! Oh my God, Audrey, are you okay?
Yes, no!
Oh my God, Audrey, don't die, please, I need you, don't die.
You know,
the plant just said the strangest thing just now. It said that Oren and Mr. Mushnik were already inside.
It's true. I did it. I fed them to the plant.
And that's how it got so big? And you're so famous?
I've done terrible things. But not to you, never to you.
But I want you to, Seymour.
What?
When I die, which will be very shortly, feed me to the plant. That way it can grow big and give you all the wonderful things you deserve.
You don't know what you're saying.
But I do. It's the one gift I can give you. And besides, if I'm in the plant, then I'm part of the plant. So in a way, we'll always be together. You wash my tender leaves. You smell my sweet perfume. Water me and care for me. You'll see me bud and bloom. I'm feeling strangely happy now, contented and serene. Oh, don't you see? Finally, I'll be somewhere that's
right in there.
Thanks, sweetheart. Krellborn? Seymour Krellborn.
Go away.
Patrick Martin, Licensing and Marketing Division, World Botanical Enterprises. I've got a gilt-edged proposition for you.
I'm not interested.
Let me explain in more detail. It's a very simple licensing deal. We take leaf cuttings, develop little Audrey 2s, and sell them to florists all across the nation. Pretty soon every household in America will have one. I've got a truck outside and some pots. If you don't mind, I'll start taking cuttings now. Imagine, boy, Audrey 2s everywhere. Why, with the right advertising, this could be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops.
Much bigger!
Every household in America, thousands of you, eating. That's what you've had in mind all along, isn't it?
No shit, Sherlock!
You're a monster. And so am I.
Feed me!
You ate the one thing I ever loved!
Too bad!
I'm ending this once and for all! Take that! And that! And that! And that! And that! I am going to kill you! Open up! Open up! Eat rat poison!
Give up, small rat!
You may be tough on the outside, but in there, in that pot, I'll hack you to bits! Open up!
Krellborn? Mr. Krellborn? All right, girls. All you have to do is take some of the smaller leaves and replant them in these pots. The truck's waiting outside. Open up the van, boys. We're ready to start loading.
Subsequent to the events you have just witnessed, similar events in cities across America, events which bore a striking resemblance to the ones you have just seen began occurring. Oh, oh, oh. Subsequent to the events you have just witnessed, unsuspecting jerks from Maine to California, California made the acquaintance of a new breed of flytrap and got sweet talked into feeding it blood. Has the plants worked their terrible will, finding jerks who would feed them their fill? As the plants proceeded to grow and grow, and began what they came here to do, which was essentially to eat Cleveland and Des Moines and Peoria.
Offer you fortune and fame, love and money and instant acclaim, but whatever they offer you, don't feed the plant. They may offer you lots of cheap thrills, fancy condos in Beverly Hills,
but whatever they offer you,
don't feed the plants. Look out, here comes Audrey too.
Here I come for you.
Hold your hat and hang on to your soul. Something's coming to eat the world whole. If we fight it, we've still got a chance. But whatever they offer you, throw this up in the trough for you. Please, whatever they offer you, don't be no man.
You'll have to know.